हेलो हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग। दिस इज डॉक्टर सालैया अशरफ कामस, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज कुकट। टुडे दिस लेसन इज ऑन थियरी एंड प्रैक्टिस। दिस सब्जेक्ट इज फॉर द बीकॉम पीपल, फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर। सो इन फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर दिस इज द कॉमन पेपर which has for the BCom companies, BCom general and BCom computer applications also. The subject name is Making Theory and Practice, and which has actually there are units. It means in this particular subject is which we have 5 units, that you know the 5 portion for the examination point of view. 80 plus 20, 80 marks is external and 20 marks is internal. And for 80 marks as well as 20 marks, and both are to be covered from these 5 units only. The 5 units, the syllabus given by our Usmania University as listen. The number one, which covers introduction. In the part of introduction, brief history of banking, types of banks, and unit banking and branch banking, and core areas of banking sector, and nationalization of banks. These are the topics which are covered. And when we go to unit number two, the unit number two title, which is Bank of India, and in the Reserve of India, which we know fully, for every country there must be one central bank. Likewise, for our India, central bank is available in the name of Reserve Bank of India. And unit 2, which covers for you people, most important one is function Reserve Bank of India, and second very important topic which is in the unit number is credit control methods executed by the Bank of India. So these are the important topics which are covered in unit number 3. And third unit, which has actually the title is types of banks in our Indian banking sector, which we have actually, there are 5 categories of banks which are classified. So the first one is commercial banks, and second is central banking, and third is cooperative banking, and next is regional rural banking, and last one is exchange, nothing but foreign exchange banks. These 4 categories which are to be covered in unit number 3. And when we unit number 4, the unit number 4 is banker and customer relationship. The banker and customer relationship. So whenever a subject, when we are discussing about banking, so banking is actually the transaction between customer and banker. Banker is the person who provides the financial assistance and financial transactions to the people. And the persons who are actually going to take the facility of the financial transactions from the organization, from a person, that we can say that customers. So relation between the banker and customer, the topic which we covered in unit number 4. And that very, very important thing is, we can say the relationship which can be classified into 2 categories, general relationship and a special relationship. So in deep and in depth, so we will discuss in unit number 4. And the last unit, syllabus, negotiable instruments. So negotiable instruments, in Telugu we can say Anya Kranta Yogyata Patra. So this negotiable instruments, which actually have here. So from a particular act, negligible instrument act, and according to that particular act, these are actually the negligible instrument which are to be classified into majorly three categories. The first one is bills of exchange, the bills, and second is promissory notes, and third one is checks. So promissory notes, bills, and these are actually three categories of negotiable instruments which are there, and those in detail and in depth, the detailed information you get in unit number 5. So as the first class of you people, first start a brief discussion of unit number 1. The unit number 1 is introduction. The introduction, when we have discussed about introduction, first, everybody knows, even better people also, they can able to say what is bank. Even if you go to this, nowadays we can say that in villages, so many people, they are taking the facility of the banking. Even if you go to coolies, even if you go to the farms, even if you go to the people who are actually so living and working in villages also, at present we think that they know what is actually the bank. But basically we can say that the financial organization which provides the deposits to the public and which provides the loans to the public. And simply we can say that bank is the organization which can accepting deposits from the public, means public who are having the surplus money, security purpose, they can deposit, they can put with the organization, and that is, we can say that bank. And the second important thing is, bank is the organization which provides the loan facility customers to the people. And these are actually the basic things the financial organization which is doing, that is simply, we can say that bank. But when we go to a small history, means when we discuss a brief history about bank, and bank organization which was started, so in oldest 1157, that we can say that bank is, that is oldest one. And afterwards in the year of 1694, we can say Bank of England. So most people, they can recognize that the oldest bank, the banking sector, is Bank of England in the year of 1994. And afterwards, when we come to India, so in India, before independence, actually there are three presidency banks which were worked. And those three presidency banks, Presidency Bank of Bombay, Presidency Bank of Bangalore, and Presidency Bank of Madras. And those three presidency banks were merged in the year of 1921 and named as Imperial Bank of India. Listen one second. Before independence in India, if we see Swatantranikante Mundu Chusinatlayite, there were three presidency banks which were there. Presidency Bank of Bangalore, Presidency Bank of Madras, Presidency Bank of Bombay. And these three presidency banks which were merged, kalishipoyayi. And after merging, so it has named as Imperial Bank of India in the year of 1920. And Imperial Bank of India later on, in the year of 1955, emerged as State Bank of India. So that is after independence. And we will say that before independence, so presidency banks and presidency banks renamed as Imperial Bank of India in the year of 1921. And afterwards, what happened, you know, in 1934, the people thought that the banking sector they should be required to monitor the head of the banks, to monitor one separate autonomous bank which is to be required. So immediately, so in those days the British government was there. So in 1934, act which was passed, that act was Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. And according to Reserve Bank of India Act 1934, year of 1935, the Reserve Bank of India has been established. And Reserve Bank of India in the year of 1935, which has been established in the private sector. This is most of the people know. And what happened is, after 1935, so after getting independence, in the year of 1949, BRA, Bank Regulation Act, which was passed. And according to that Banking Regulation Act 1949, the Reserve Bank of India was established in the private sector in the year of 1935, has been nationalized in the year of 1949. So here, if you discuss the history of the banking sector, so there are two sections we had to understand. Independence, after independence. So before independence, the banking sector which was there in the private sector, means the banking sector which is there in the hands of private people. Even if you take presidencies, were there in the private people? Even they are merged together and incorporated as Central Bank of India in the year of 1921, in private hands. Even if you Reserve Bank of India, according to Supreme Act 1934, established, and 1935, in the private hands only. And after independence only in the year of 1949, first has taken for the banking sector is, we have to say that it is a milestone for banking sector, Banking Regulation Act 1949. And according to that 1949 Banking Regulation Act, Reserve Bank of India has been nationalized. And up to this, so I am concluding the today's lesson, and we will discuss tomorrow of the part after independence, and after that definition and types of the bank. Thank you, one and all.